Hello everyone, I want to give you an introduction how PLM change management is handled in SAP S4HANA. The following functionalities are available in S4HANA on-premise, starting with release 2020 FPS1, as well as on cloud systems, starting with S4HANA Cloud Edition 2208. In this video, I want to give you an overview how the change record impact analysis is working. I will first show some slides and then jump into the system for a live demo. Please note that we have used the latest S4HANA on-premise system, which is currently shipped to our customers. It has the state of S4HANA 2021 FPS0. Before we start using the impact analyzer, we first need to set up the object entities we want to model in our analyzer. This is happening in a S-Pro customizing table. In this table, we are defining the object entities, so for example, BOM header, material, or change record. These different object entities will be available then in our graphical view of the impact modeler. In addition, we also need to maintain per change record type, which impact analysis model is used per change object. For sure, this could be only done after we have our impact models available. This brings us to our next point, the scenario modeling. The scenario modeling is happening in the Fiori app of the impact modeler. In the modeler, you can choose between a graphical and a tabular view. The graphical view will display all object entities you maintained in the customizing and is used for simple impact scenarios. In the tabular view, you have control about all the different entities which are available in SAP. Therefore, the tabular view can be used for more complex impact analysis scenarios. It is also possible to switch between the graphical and the tabular view. Besides the object entities, you can also maintain the impact rules to define from when an object is impacted. A rule could be a filter or a condition. A filter is, for example, all bombs are impacted which are in plant 1000. A condition can define if and then scenarios. So for example, if a material is a finished product, then the BOM needs to be in plant 1000. Once our impact model is available, we can execute the model on the change record item level. With this, we can analyze which of the modeled objects are impacted by our change. During impact analyzing, we could also switch between different scenarios. Let's now jump into the system to have a closer look how the impact analysis is working. So first of all, we need to maintain the object entities in the S4 customizing table. Therefore, we are accessing our already known path in the S4 customizing for the change record. This goes via Logistics General, Product Lifecycle Management, Change Records, and then Impact Management. In the impact management, we have this table of the defined impact modeler objects available. In the first column, we are selecting which object types we want to include in our impact analysis. For example, in this case, we have here already added a material, or a bill of material header, or a change record. The entities of the last column are automatically getting filling out by selecting the object types on the F4 help. These external object names are describing the name, which will be then later available on the graphical view of our Impact Analysis Modeler app. To show you where these entries are later available in the system, we are switching to our Fiori application. In our Fiori, we're opening the app of the Manage Impact Analysis Models to model some new scenarios. On the overview page, we have all the different scenarios available, which are already created in the system. In our case, we are creating a new scenario. We can give it a name. We can give it a description. Clicking Create. After that, we are automatically landing in the graphical view of the draft mode of this model. Via this button, we can add here these different objects, what we have just added in the customizing table. So here you see all the different objects available, what we have maintained in the S-Pro customizing. In this example, we want to create a pretty easy scenario, which is showing the relation from a material to a bomb header to, for example, a change record. Therefore, we are first of all adding the material object. Once the material object is added, we are selecting it and then adding the object of the material bomb header. And then you see that the relation between these material and bomb header is shown via this arrow in between. As a next step, we want to see in which kind of change master this bomb header is already included in. Therefore, we're selecting the bomb header and adding the object of the change master. Thereafter, the change master is added. When you are executing now this impact model out of a material, you will then see if this material does also exist as a bomb header and if such a bomb header does then also exist in a change master. You are now aware of the graphical view of this impact analysis model. With the graphical view, you can impact such easy and simple scenarios. What we now also can do is switching from the graphical to the tabular view in the upper right corner of the screen. In the tabular view, you will see then all these models builded on the tabular table, what you have just maintained on the graphical view. Besides these object entities, you can also maintain the impact rules to define if an object is impacted or not. These rules I will explain you in another example. Let's publish our just created model. To show you some more complex models, we will switch to a scenario what I have already created. Switching to the graphical view, you will see the relation of these different objects. Here we have maintained the relation from a material to a change record. So a system will show all the change records where this material is already considered, as well as the relation from a material to a bomb item. So this will give you information of the material where you're executing the impact analysis does already exist as a material bomb item. And in addition to that, it will also show you the related bomb where this material is part of. In this example, we have also added some rules to identify if the related material is really impacted or not. These rules you have available on the constraints section of the tabular view. Here you see, for example, the rule of a filter. So in this case, we only want to show material bombs items which are coming from the plant 001. In addition, we said, okay, if the material bomb item is coming from the plant 001, then the material bomb header needs to be out of a variant 01. To show you how these impact analyses get executed on the change record, we first of all need to maintain the scenario in the S-Pro customizing. Therefore, we are jumping back to the customizing and accessing the settings for the engineering record and the table of the defined engineering change record types. In this table, we need to maintain per change record type the default impact scenario for each object. Here you see that we have already added our just shown scenario material to bomb to change record for the object type of the material. So this means once we are executing the impact analysis on material level, the scenario what you just have seen gets automatically executed. Let's jump into the change record app to see how this works in the system. Therefore, we are accessing the manage change records app. We are selecting an existing change record, in this case of the type DIS. We are switching to the material section, selecting one material, and then executing the impact analysis via the Analyze Impact button. Here you see that our scenario of the material to bomb to CR automatically gets executed. In addition, you then see where this material 27 is part of which change record. We have here overall 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 change records where this material is already part of. In addition, we also see if this material already exists as a BOM item. In this example, we see that this material does exist as two BOM items parts. The related BOM header is also displayed here. In this view, we can also switch to different scenarios. Opening the F4 help, we can easily access the scenario what we just have created in the beginning. In the just modeled scenario, we see that this material does not exist as a BOM header. Thank you, everyone. I hope I give you an overview how the impact analysis is working. You should now understand what setup is required, how you can model scenario in a graphical as well as in a tabular view, and how you can execute the impact analysis on a change record item level.